ರಾಮ ರಾಮ ಹರೆ 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 ಕೃಷ್ಣ Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram Hare Ram 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 Hare 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 Krishna Radha Madhav Radha Madhav Radhe Jayo Panchatattva 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 Jayo Panchatattva Jaya Jaya Prabhupada 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 Nita Gaura Hari Bol Hari Bol Hari Bol Hari Bol Srila Prabhupada ki Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha Sri Chaitanya Manobishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swabhat Vandeham Sri Guru Sri Yuta Padakamalam Sri Gurum Vaishnavamsya श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगना रघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनासहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगना ललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमत् भक्तिवेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने नमस्ते सारस्वतीदेवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वांछाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यः एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो पंचतत्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्तक्यां नमामि भक्तशक्तिकां नित्यानन्दमहं नौमि सर्वानन्दकरं परं हरिनाम पदं देवं अवधूतशिरोमणिं नमो महावदान्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनामिने गौरद्विषे नमः हे कृष्ण करुणासिन्धु दीनबन्धु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांता राधा कांता नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानु सुते देवी प्रणमामि हरि प्रिय जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे सो टुडे विल reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 9th canto, 7th chapter, shloka 1 to 7. Traishankavo Harishchandro त्रैशंखवो हरिश्चंद्रो विश्वामित्रा वशिष्ठयो विश्वामित्रा वशिष्ठयो यन्निमित्तम् अभूद्युद्धम् यन्निमित्तम् अभूद्युद्धम् पक्षिनोर् बहु वार्षिकम् पक्षिनोर् बहु वार्षिकम् त्रैशंखवो हरिश्चंद्रो विश्वामित्रा वशिष्ठयो यन्निमित्तम् अभूद्युद्धम् पक्षिनोर् बहु वार्षिकम् त्रैशंखवो हरिश्चंद्रो विश्वामित्रा वशिष्ठयो यन्निमित्तम् अभूद्युद्धम् पक्षिनोर् बहु वार्षिकम् त्रैशंखवो हरिश्चंद्रो शंकवो हरिश्चंद्रो विश्वामित्रा वशिष्ठयो यन्निमित्तम् अभूद्युद्धम् पक्षिणो बहुवार्षिकम् थैंक
Mataji's place.
Trai Shankhavo Harishchandro Vishwamitra Vasishtayo Annimittam Yuddham Pakshino Bahuvarshikam Trai Shankhavo Harishchandro Vishwamitra Vasishtayo Trai Shankhavo Harishchandro Trishankavo, the son of Trishanku, Harishchandra, by the name Harishchandra, Vishwamitra Vasishtayo, between Vishwamitra and Vasishta, Yat Nimittam. Because of Harishchandra, Habut, there was Yuddham, a great fight. Pakshino, both of whom had been converted into birds, Bahuvarshikam, for many years. Translation and purport by Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada ki. The son of Trishanku was Harishchandra. Because of Harishchandra, there was a quarrel between Vishwamitra and Vasishta, who for many years fought one another, having been transformed into birds. Purport. Vishwamitra and Vasishta were always inimical. Formerly, Vishwamitra was a Kshatriya, and by undergoing severe austerities, he wanted to become a Brahmana. But Vasishta would not agree to accept him. In this way, there was always disagreement between the two. Later, however, Vasishta accepted him because of Vishwamitra's quality of forgiveness. Once Harishchandra performed a yajna for which Vishwamitra was the priest. But Vishwamitra, being angry at Harishchandra, took away all his possessions, claiming them as a contribution of Dakshina. Vasishta, however, did not like this, and therefore a fight arose between Vasishta and Vishwamitra. The fighting became so severe that each of them cursed the other. One of them said, "May you become a bird." And the other said, "May you become duck." Thus, both of them became birds and continued fighting for many years because of Harishchandra. We can see that such a great mystic yogi as Shaubari became a victim of sense gratification, and such great sages as Vasishta and Vishwamitra became birds. This is the material world. Abrahma Bhuvana Loka Punaravartino Arjuna. Within this material world or within this universe, however elevated one may be in material qualities, one must suffer the conditions of birth, death, old age and disease. Janma Mrityu Jara Vyadi. Therefore, Krishna says that this material world is simply miserable. Dukhalayam Ashashvatam. The Bhagavatam says, Padam Padam Yad Vipadam. At every step, here there is danger. Therefore,
Because the Krishna consciousness movement provides the opportunity for the human being to get out of this material world simply by chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, this movement is the greatest benediction in human society. I'll read out the first two other. Just translations I'm reading out. Sukadeva Goswami said, the most prominent among the sons of Mandata was he who is celebrated as Ambarisha. Ambarisha was accepted as son by his grandfather Yavanashva. Ambarisha's son was Yavanashva, and Yavanashva's son was Harita in Mandata's dynasty. Ambarisha, Harita and Yavanashva were very prominent. Second, the serpent brothers of Narmada gave Narmada to Purukutsa. Being sent by Vasuki, she took Purukutsa to the lower region of the universe. Before describing the descendants of Purukutsa, the son of Mandata, Sukadeva Goswami first describes how Purukutsa was married to Narmada, who was induced to take him to the lower region of the universe. There is Rasatala, the lower region of the universe. Purukutsa, being empowered by Lord Vishnu, was able to kill all the Gandharvas who deserved to be killed. Purukutsa received the benediction from the serpents that anyone who remembers this history of his being brought by Narmada to the lower region of the universe will be assured of safety from the attack of snakes. Fourth, the son of Purukutsa was Trashadasyu, who was the father of Anaranya. Anaranya's son was Haryasva, the father of Praruna. Praruna was the father of Tribandana. Fifth and sixth. The son of Tribandana was Satyavrata, who is celebrated by the name Trishanku, because he kidnapped the daughter of a Brahmana. When she was being married, his father cursed him to become a Chandala, lower than a Shudra. Thereafter, by the influence of Vishwamitra, he went to the higher planetary system, the heavenly planets, in his material body. But because of the prowess of the demigods, he fell back downward. Nonetheless, by the power of Vishwamitra, he did not fall all the way down. Even today, he can still be seen hanging in the sky, head downward. Today's verse translation. The son of Trishanku was Harishchandra. Because of Harishchandra, there was a quarrel between Vishwamitra and Vasishta, who for many years fought one another, having been transformed into birds. First of all, I seek blessings from all the senior Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis, especially from Prabhupada disciples, Jaranivas Prabhu, Sannyasis. I am not eligible to give a class on Bhagavatam, but for my purification, I accepted this. So, in the earlier chapter, as we see, that Shaubari Muni has fallen down. And Shaubari Muni was glorified by Mandata even. Mandata was a great personality, but still he was so opulent, more than the Mandata. So Mandata was also glorifying the Shaubari Muni. And Shaubari Muni was having 50 wives and 5,000 children and opulent life and sense gratification also in very high level. We cannot even imagine. So at that stage, after few years, means after 100 years of enjoyment, he realized that he fall down from his high level spiritual position where he was practicing meditation. So he repented for that how I fall down. Again he left the wife and opulent life, went for meditation. So in comparison to that Shaubari Muni, we cannot even imagine in front of him. And we are also interested in different types of sense gratification. And the Shaubari Muni's example, by his, we can learn that at last Shaubari Muni was repenting and left the household life. We can learn that anyhow one has to leave home one day. So we have to prepare mentally from now onwards that one day I have to leave home. May not be possible to leave home and stay in the jungle, or may not be possible to accept the sannyasa formally or externally, but we can act like a sannyasa. Many grihastha devotees are there. They are in household life, but they are practicing very seriously Krishna consciousness, not so much attached to the family household life. So one should practice. Now onwards we have to practice. Like when we are going to back to Godhead, we don't know, but we are practicing now. In the material platform also, when we are going to achieve some money and sense gratification, we don't know. We know at least after 25 years, 23 years, we enjoy. But from the childhood onwards, for that sense gratification to earn money, from childhood we are having education. So from now onwards, one should practice. One should think of it, plan for that, how to leave this material household affairs and detach from this household life and engage in Krishna consciousness little more seriously. So one can practice that, plan for that future, like going into vanprastha ashram or sannyasa ashram, totally detached from the household affairs. So by that we can liberate, we can help the dependents like wife, children. They will learn from that we have learned from Shaubari Muni's lifestyle, life story, that their wives, 50 wives also got liberated. They went to spiritual world, it is said. It is of the seriousness of the husband. So one should be serious in Krishna consciousness. And we can also see that in Vishwamitra's life, that he was a very great rishi, but he has fallen on from his spiritual position to household affairs again. So he was also lamenting, he was also repenting that how it happened like that. So we can learn this, that in material world, either a brahmachari, he can think that by this we can learn that in grihastha life there is no happiness. Of course, in the purport, Prabhupada also mentioning that it is all dukkhalayam, ashashvatam. But even though we brahmacharis can think that, yeah, anyhow there is no happiness, an intelligent man, by seeing the example, by hearing from the authorities, they will take the decision. And the Grihasthas, by seeing this, we can, most of the Grihasthas, they might have realized, and they can also plan to get out of this household affairs and engage in Krishna consciousness to please the acharyas as well as to get benefited the self. Okay. So Bhishma, Vishwamitra was a great king. His name was Vishwarath, and he was a great Kshatriya king. He went for so many days in the forest for hunting, and while returning he was little tired and he liked to take little rest. Then he came across an ashram which was Vasishtha Rishis. So he entered there in the ashram. As soon as the Vasishtha heard the sound, he came out and he welcomed the king and he offered water, and as they got fresh up, by the time he has arranged a good feast prasadam for them. As that Vasishtha was having one Nandini cow, the calf of Kamadenu. It was gifted by the heavenly planets, demigods. So he was taking care of it, and it was utilized for others' benefit it was. So as soon as this they saw, the Vishwamitra was surprised. How can these, for the whole soldiers he has arranged the feast. He was surprised. And after that they took prasadam, they slept, and early in the morning they were planning to leave. By the time they got fresh up, Vishwamitra arranged again the breakfast also. So now he could not stop himself, that he inquired, how it is possible by you, how you are in a short period, you have arranged so many things for us. Then Vasishtha introduced about the Nandini cow. As soon as he saw that, Vishwamitra desired to have that cow. It is natural as a king. So he requested him, but Vishwamitra refused it. Vasishtha refused. He was saying that it is not for my use. It has been given by the demigods for welfare activities, others' benefits you can use. And I myself also won't use for my sense gratification. So I cannot give this. As a king, he may have that authority that he can take it. Whatever is, you know, took birth or whatever is grown in the earth where he is ruling, he may have the right to have it. But Vasishtha is saying that this belongs to this world. This is not from this earthly planet. It is coming from the heavenly planet. So I cannot give this. And I am not using for my sense gratification. And if you take it, you will use it for your sense gratification. And anyhow, this will not help you. But Vishwamitra was not ready to accept this. So he took it forcefully. Forcefully he took it. And At the time of they are taking it, the Nandini understood the intention of Vasishtha, and from Nandini is like a Kamadenu. Whatever we desire, she can give. So she produced, the cow produced so many soldiers, and with these soldiers, the Vishwamitra's whole soldiers were defeated, even Vishwamitra also. So he could not do anything. Then he left. Then he inquired about this, how it is possible. Then it's like spiritual power. Then Vishwamitra inclined to be a Brahmana, to have some spiritual potencies, spiritual power. Then he started engaged in the meditation. So when he is engaged, like different levels are Rishi, Maharishi, then Brahma Rishi. So gradually he became a rishi by having knowledge, and then Maharishi, he was realized, then Brahmarishi, realizing about the self. So Brahmarishi is the topmost position in the material world. He can reside in the Brahma Loka, and even the more powerful than the demigods. So with that power, he influenced to pass or place this Trishanku in the heavenly planets. But heavenly planets, the demigods were not accepting. Later on, he has created by his mystic powers some different world. It is, I heard that. But Prabhupada is saying that it is hanging. He is not in the heavenly planets and not in the material world, earthly planets. So he is hanging in between. So in this material world, the sense gratification, any time we may fall down, any time we may get illusioned. So on 24th of Prabhupada's quote, on 24th, he was saying, to the sincere devotee, this ocean of Maya is easily crossed by the cool breeze of Krishna's grace. This is our business, to submit to Krishna's desire to have us back with him in eternal sky of Krishna Loka. So one can control our senses by Krishna consciousness, not by this yoga, meditation or jnana. It is not possible. And in whole Bhagavatam, this is all glorified. The devotional service, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and the devotees who have engaged in the devotional service of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So earlier chapters we were seeing that, you know, like some people were, the kings were engaged in the ritualistic activities, yajñas, and that was refuted. Sukadev Goswami is also preaching in the same way, and Prabhupada is also refuting in the purports, like Jnana Yoga is waste, and Karma Yoga is waste, ritualistic activities is waste. We cannot achieve the topmost perfection, highest goal of life. And at last the yoga, the Ashtanga Yoga is also not possible to attain the highest perfection, highest goal of life. So by this we can understand that the importance of the devotional service. So when we understand about this devotional service, then only we will be inclined or convinced to be serious in Krishna consciousness. So that is what it is trying, the Bhagavatam is trying to convince the all the devotees to be in Krishna consciousness somehow or other, engage in Krishna consciousness. So this Krishna consciousness, due to the false ego, due to the influence of the false ego, due to the influence of the Kali also, we may get attracted to the illusions, illusory energy, and this is possible also by only when we are on bodily platform. So one should be trying to raise from the bodily platform to the soul. So Shastra, it is said that bhukti mukti siddhi kami shakali asanti krishna bhakto nishkam ata eva shanti. Means in the bhukti mukti, all these are, when whatever we are getting in this material world, material opulent life, these are all creates ashanti, there is no shanti. But as Krishna Bhakti, as soon as we engaged in Krishna Bhakti, we will have a shanti. So we will be peace, we will be able to engage peaceful when we engage in the Krishna consciousness. As Krishna also says in Bhagavad Gita, Bhoktaram Yagatapasam Sarvaloka Maheshwaram Suhidam Sarvabhutanam Jnatvamam Shanti Mirichate. The peace formula. One has to know about that, the supremacy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and engage in his devotional service. Once that, you know, after engaging in the yoga, different kinds of yoga process, the benefits are all material. Like once Prabhupada, one devotee came to Prabhupada and he was saying that one person is walking on the water. And Prabhupada saying that, Prabhupada asked him, you have got this mystic power to walk on the water. So how many years you struggled for this? Then he told that around 40 years he struggled. Oh, 40 years you struggled and you got only this much. And this thing, we can cross the water by 25 paisa. That much you have earned for 40 years engaged in some mystic yoga. So this is what the, other than Krishna consciousness, any yoga process gives only the material benefits, and that too we will not get the satisfaction. Until one engages in the devotional service, we cannot control our senses. It's not that we have to control the senses, but we have to divert the senses into Krishna's service. That is Krishna consciousness. So Krishna's devotional service. But Krishna consciousness devotional service is not so easy to understand, because unless and until we understand what is Krishna, supremacy of Krishna, we cannot engage in Krishna consciousness. So it is not so easy, and everybody cannot engage in devotional service. So one has to understand about Krishna, that he is not ordinary man. And even the devotional service is also not ordinary thing. But if we follow simply Lord Chaitanya's instructions, Lord Chaitanya's footsteps, then we can understand what is devotional service. Prabhupada is saying in one song's purport that Gaurangera Dutipada, Jardhan Sampada. If we are catching a hold of the two lotus feet of Lord Gauranga, then we will be enjoying. So in that purport, Prabhupada is saying that simply by chanting the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, can understand what devotional service is. So Lord Chaitanya's movement is very easy, simply by chanting, dancing and eating prasadam. By chanting, dancing and eating prasadam, we can understand, and the pastimes of the Lord also we can understand. So Prabhupada is saying that simply by chanting, dancing, eating prasada, the dirty things in the heart will become cleansed. Simply by chanting. In the purport of this today's shloka, Prabhupada is saying that the glories of the Krishna consciousness by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. This movement is the greatest benediction in human society. So for this whole human society, Prabhupada has created this ISKCON so that we can take the advantage of it and get rid of this material miseries, get rid of this material world and go back to the Godhead. So simply by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, we can get so many benefits. We can understand a devotional service, what is it actually? And we can get cleaned by chanting, dancing, eating prasadam. The dirty things in the heart all will become cleansed. So Narottam Das Thakur is singing like this songs. Gaurangera Madhur Leela Jar Karne Praveshila Hridaya Nirmal Boletar. So just by hearing, by chanting, by dancing, our Hridaya, the heart will be purified. So simply by chanting Sri Krishna's chanting, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Nityananda, immediately develops the love of Godhead. In the same song's purport, Prabhupada is giving like this. Six times he is saying, simply by chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra, simply by chanting, dancing and taking prasadam, dirty things will be clean. Simply, if you simply by chanting Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda, one immediately develops love of Godhead. Simply appreciating Lord Chaitanya's movement immediately enters into and understand the Radha Krishna's eternal pastime, which is the highest perfectional stage of devotional service. And simply by accepting the associates of Lord Chaitanya as eternally free, one can immediately be promoted to the transcendental abode of Lord Krishna. If one simply understands the land of Navadvipa is non-different from Vrindavan, then he actually lives in Vrindavan. So the glories of the Krishna consciousness or chanting the holy name are unlimited. So I don't have that qualities to glorify the unlimited glories of the Supreme Personality of Godhead's names. I'll stop here. If any comments, suggestions, questions.
Hare Krishna. Prabhuji, in the beginning we were discussing about how we should plan to get out of this material world and practice detachment from household life. Is it possible that we plan how to constantly engage in devotional service and we naturally develop detachment simultaneously? We also act our role perfectly as a householder. Is it possible, or we have to practice how to develop detachment?
Yeah. What you are saying is right. We can engage seriously in Krishna consciousness. Like, you know, one may focus on the negative things to, I don't want. Like one example is there, like material things are there, I don't want, you are saying, and pushing it back. And you are going towards the material things, but you leave it and you come towards Krishna consciousness. You try to engage in Krishna consciousness. Automatically this distance is increased. In that way we can get detached. And as soon as when we engage in Krishna consciousness, we will get detachment. But after some time again, we may get attached. So one should be always check anukulyasya sankalpa, pratikulyasya varjanam, rakshishyatiti vishvaso, Goptirtri Varanam Tata. That is like a mirror, that how we are advancing or not. Either whether we are surrendering to Lord or not. In that way we can check once in a while and engage seriously. The 24 hours are there. These 24 hours, how much time you are engaged in material activities and how much time you are engaged in the spiritual activities. The time has to be increased in spiritual activities. Automatically you are detached. Is it okay?
Seemingly it may look material, like maintaining our body or whatever activities are there. But to engage in devotional service, would that be considered material when we are trying to maintain our body so that we can engage in the service? So how do we understand and distinguish that I'm giving limited time to material activities and I'm giving this much time to spiritual?
Yeah, material activities when we are engaging to maintain our body. But in non-devotees also, you see, when they become old, they are not earning for their maintenance of the body. So in future, we will not work. This is what advancement. Anyhow, we will not work. Even though we won't work, we will get maintenance is possible without working. We are doing that. We are not working. But maintenance is going on very nicely. Yes, Mother. It's okay, Mother.
I was thinking of talking about Thakur, who said that he offers everything, his home, his children, his wife, his family, everything he's offering to Krishna. He doesn't see anything as his own. So if you look at his schedule, you know, sometimes his schedule is published,
It's quite astounding, his schedule. And if you look how many hours this, how many hours that, you know, he's in the court. But everything he's doing is for Krishna. So it's really a matter of consciousness more than of clocking the hours. It's really a matter of looking at the consciousness of the person and seeing, is he really doing everything for Krishna?
Thank you. Question? One may not, in the beginning of our devotional service, we may not be able to engage in Krishna consciousness 24 hours. But gradually it happens. And one should not try to engage 24 hours in Krishna consciousness. It's like artificial it will be. Because we don't have from inside that attachments to our Lord, and we are trying to do it. And we may get, some disturbances. So better to be, like devotional service it is said, it's like gradually it will advance. We will be advancing in Krishna consciousness. Gradual process it is.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, thank you very much for your wonderful explanation about Narottam Das Thakur's song. But my little bit question about this, like Vishwamitra and Vasishtha Muni, they are in Bhagavatam. And you quote this peace formula, Bhokta Ram Yagatapsa. It looks like that they don't know this formula and they are fighting. So I want to understand how they are in Bhagavatam and they don't understand this peace formula.
Later it is said that they were engaged in, Vishwamitra was meditating on Ram and he got perfected. But in the earlier stage, this fighting and all things were going on in an immature state. Otherwise they could not control even anger. Okay, thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki.